Deborah, hi. Come in.
Thanks. I can't stay long.
Right.
What's wrong, Dermot? Normally ask me out twice before we've even reached the kitchen.
Got the sack today.
Oh, no. Why?
Had an argument with a customer.
Oh, well, if that was a sacking offence, I wouldn't have any staff.
Well, it wasn't just an argument. Picked him up and dangled him by his feet until he stopped calling me Mr. Stinker.
This is a child, is it?
Yeah. Children in that toy department can be so hurtful.
Well, I think I would have let you off with a warning.
I'd already had a written warning for calling another one a stunted little turd.
Well, maybe you shouldn't work with children.
No, this was an old lady in the china department.
Maybe you shouldn't work with human beings.
Do you need anyone in your restaurant?
Oh, Dermot, I don't know.
You said you were short-staffed.
You've got a record of dangling people by their ankles.
No, that's it. I'm through with dangling.
Have you worked as a waiter before?
Yeah.
Where?
Tiny place in Scotland. It's closed down now.
Oh, well. I suppose we could give you a try.
Oh, brilliant! Didn't even have to wear my lucky interview underpants.
No, you've just got to get your face out of my neck.
We're sharing a magic moment.
Oh, speak for yourself, Dermot.
Put it down, Dermot. You're making a fool of yourself.
You're just giving me a job.
Well, you already had a job.
Got made redundant.
You're never made redundant. You're always fired.
Hi, Gary. Nice day at the office?
Pretty standard. George spent the day showing how to make a model windmill out of paper clips. Anthony had a nervous breakdown in her lunch hour, fortunately. And I filled my briefcase with yogurt.
Billy banana flavour. My favourite.
Well, I must go. I came to ask you if you could move some of your things out of the garden shed to make room for some of my stuff.
Sure. What do you got?
Oh, a lawnmower, tools.
What, gardening things?
Yes, Dermot. How do you cut the grass?
Well, we just sort of flatten it down.
It seems to stop growing after a while. How did you persuade Deborah to give you a job?
Tell her I had experience.
Have you?
Not yet.
What is your work record? What a mess.
These are my wilderness years. Like Churchill and Gary Glitter.
I bet Churchill was never kicked out of Security Corps for leaving the keys in the ignition while he did a bit of shopping.
There was a sale on.
You've got no ambition, have you?
Have?
I'm talking about careers, Dermot. Not your ambition to clash glands with Linda Lusardi. What did you want to be when you were a kid?
Rock guitarist.
Yeah.
What, you too?
No. Manager of a small engineering firm.
Funny, isn't it? The crazy dreams we once had.
Crazy.
I reckon I could still be a guitarist, you know, if I learned to play guitar.
For a while, I wanted to be that little girl on the test card playing noughts and crosses.
Yeah, well, didn't we all? Then after that, you want any job where there's lots of women around.
Mm, mm.
I wanted to be choreographer for Pan's People. Sent off for details, actually.
My parents just wanted me to have a respectable job.
Oh, you've done all right, then.
Yeah. Nothing wrong with my career. I give my best years to high-quality security equipment. I mean, look at Dermot. He's been around. He's had lots of interesting jobs. Briefly. Now, tell you, we once nearly sold a pair of shoes to Bamba Gascoigne.
It probably wasn't as exciting as it sounds.
No, I'm sure it wasn't.
I was excited for a while. Back in the 1960s. Found it rather worrying.
Now Dermot's going to be working with Deborah. George, when was the last time we had somebody young and attractive in this office?
Oh, I think that must have been Cindy.
No, you can't count Anthony as dog, George.
No, I suppose not.
You know, when I first came here, within 3 years, I was going to have 2 pert secretaries and an executive drinks cabinet. What have I got? Anthea and a flask.
What do you want 2 secretaries for?
I don't know. I think I was going to take one home at the weekends.
I've got the biscuits you like, George.
That's the entertainment budget shot to pieces.
Thank you. I was wondering, Anthea, maybe next week we could experiment tentatively with some Garibaldi.
This is what it's like at the cutting edge of British industry. Don't rush off, Anthea. I'm going to ask you something. Do you see me as a dynamic entrepreneur or a complete failure? Well, it's not that hard, is it? I'm obviously not a complete failure.
I think I know the answer to that.
Let me put it another way. Do you think this is the right environment for an ambitious and thrusting young executive?
Well, isn't it more important just to be happy?
Well, it's nice, but it's not...
No! I think too many young people are scrambling to get ahead at the expense of older people. I'm sorry, but that's what I think.
Bloody hell. What was all that ranting about? I thought Ian Paisley walked in the room.
I think she's a bit sensitive. It's her birthday on Saturday.
What, again? Didn't we get her something last year to cheer her up?
Yes, a new in tray.
Oh. Did it cheer her up?
I don't think so.
Oh, we can't give her that again then, can we?
Best present I ever had was a little blue tricycle. But I suppose that's a boy's thing, really.
George, I think it's time we did something special for Anthea. I sometimes get the impression she's afraid of me.
Oh, I think you're being oversensitive.
Why don't I take us all out for a really nice meal?
Anthea has a bit of a sensitive stomach. We'd have to take her somewhere where she'd be looked after. Listen to this. A customer you are serving has a piece of food stuck on his chin. Do you A, ignore it, B, tell the diner the problem in a jocular manner, or C, remove the offending piece with a serviette?
C. A.
Well, it depends, doesn't it? I mean, if it was a great big strip of carrot or something, it'd be funnier just to leave it there.
What's the answer?
The answer, B, tell the diner the problem. See Appendix 3 for a selection of jocular remarks.
I remember the first time Gary and I went out for a meal together. He spent half an hour with a piece of cucumber at the corner of his mouth.
What did you do?
I leaned across the table and sucked it off.
Right then.
We were romantic in those days.
Yeah. This'll give us some ideas. My parents used to play it with me.
Mm. Who's the postman? An amusing career game for young folk.
What else do you find in the shed?
Oh, nothing as fun as this.
Let's play with the lawnmower.
No! Dorothy, you can be the doctor's wife. Who do you want to be, Dermot?
Well, don't I get a choice?
That's the only woman left. I lost the assistant librarian.
You can be the smug little bastard in the suit.
No! My parents always let me be the accountant. You can be the baker.
You both have real jobs and I'm just somebody's wife.
Oh, look, I'm just as much a feminist as you are, Dorothy, but we've got to stick to the rules, eh?
I could be the engineer.
No, you're a girl.
You purchase an imprudent brand of flour. Cool, this is terrifying. Acquire two blue collar cards. Whoa.
Your husband picks up something nasty in the surgery. Lose one climber token while you restore him to health.
Oh, come on, you two. This is educational. It'll help you with your careers.
There's nothing wrong with my career that a decent salary wouldn't improve.
Well, you nurses do an excellent job, but it's not a proper job, is it? Well, I mean, of course it is a proper job, yes, but it's in a sort of public service kind of a caring sort of a way. The chaps in your department award you a popularity prize. Earn 15 guineas.
You're so smug, aren't you? You sell burglar alarms in a dingy little office for a dead-end company, and you come on like you're achieving something.
Oh, I see.
The other day, somebody at work asked me what you did for a living. I told them you were unemployed. It seemed more impressive.
That office would close down without me. I'm responsible for people.
I suppose I just push a tea trolley.
I think you do an excellent job, Dorothy.
Thank you, Dermot.
In a really sexy uniform.
Uh-oh, looks like trouble. You lose both thumbs in a kneading machine. Miss six turns. Oh, no.
You don't have to worry about me. I've got a standing offer of a managerial job at Vulcan Technology.
Well, go on, then. What are you waiting for? Take the job.
When the time is right for me to showcase my talents on a broader canvas, then I will.
If you're scared of taking on a new job, Gary, just say so.
Gary, is this yours?
Yeah, I found it in the shed.
God, I always wanted a Johnny Seven. Let's play war.
Yeah, no girls.
We're ready to order now.
Okay.
I'll go for the souffle roquefort and mange tout.
One cheesy thing with the flat peas. And for your sumptuous girlfriend.
What's in the sauce maison?
Oh, you know these French chefs, they'll stick in their own grandmother if it improves the colour. Oh, just being jocular. No, it's sort of mushy. I think there might be a few prawns.
Yeah, perhaps I'll have the chicken salad.
Chicken salad. Thank you, darling. Thank you.
Dermot, the kitchen staff are getting slightly confused. You've put here, glasses, no neck.
Yeah, that's the bloke over there. So I can tell who's having what.
Right, that would explain. Perfume, fantastic breasts.
Sorry.
Stick to the table number, Dermot.
Okay.
Hi.
Hello.
Has he flambéed anyone's trousers yet?
No, not yet. I've put you over here.
Thanks.
Special occasion, is it? Gary's entertaining his staff. Oh, that's generous.
Well, would be if I wasn't about to sack them.
You're not sacking them, Gary. You're resigning.
I've told you, it amounts to the same thing. The company will close that office down without me. Even if they don't, do you think a new boss is going to keep George and Anthea on?
Well, they're probably better off moving on anyway.
I mean, Anthea jabbers away to herself like she's a victim of some awful laboratory experiment.
I bet she was all right till she met you.
George is about as easy to understand as Birmingham.
Anything to drink?
Oh, God, you're not serving us, are you?
I'm fresh and enthusiastic.
No, you're untrained, incompetent, clumsy and probably dangerous.
Same thing, same thing.
Anthea's going to be jumpy enough without you tipping a halibut down the back of her dress.
Leave it out, will you? Try to impress Deborah.
I'll have a vodka and tonic, please, Dermot. And Gary will have a straw and a bottle of the house white to calm him down.
You'll have to tell George and Anthea, I can't.
It's typically arrogant of you to assume they can't go on without you.
They can't. Have you ever watched George trying to unstaple his tie from a piece of paper?
Telling them. You're the captain of industry. I just push a tea trolley, remember?
You forced me into this job in the first place. It's Macbeth, isn't it? All over again, exactly.
Oh, exactly. Macbeth. That's the play about a burglar alarm salesman who ruthlessly accepts a job just outside Hendon, egged on by a nurse without a proper job.
I'm not a burglar alarm salesman. I'm a security consultant.
Look, Gary, the whole... Oh, hello.
Oh, hello.
Happy birthday.
Very nice.
Happy birthday, Anthea.
Thank you.
Pretty brooch.
Oh, I got that with my first salary check from Gary. So I thought this was a good time to wear it.
Well, we should do this every year.
Ah, well, who can tell where we'll be this time next year, George?
Oh, I think this job will see me through to retirement.
Well, that's a comforting thought, isn't it? How about a drink, George?
Oh, here we are.
Thank you.
Hello, Dermot. What are you doing here?
I'm branching out into a new career.
This is what, to supplement your income?
No, this is the new career. There you go, mate. And for you, madam, the moist, tender breast of chicken, delicately mounted on a bed of pouting greenery. Enjoy your meal.
If my girlfriend wants you to slobber over her, I'm sure she'll ask.
You think I've got a chance, then?
Okay.
What about the pork? That hasn't got anything foreign in it.
You sure it doesn't come with anything peculiar?
Pork in a cream and mushroom sauce. Sounds like tremendous fun.
I suppose I could scrape the sauce off if I don't like it.
Well, there you go, Anthea.
But I don't like pork, though. I'm sorry. I'm holding you all up.
No, you take all the time you want, Anthea.
Right, so how are you doing?
Silly bitch can't make her mind up.
Well, maybe if you tell me what you want, I'll see if Chef can rustle it up.
Well, what I really fancy is a bowl of cereal.
No, at times, Gary can be frighteningly efficient. Makes me look a bit of a bumbler.
I expect you save yourself when you're at home.
Oh, good Lord, no. When I get home, I go all vague and dithery.
We're a bit of a happy family, really, in the office. Well, the nearest I get to having one, anyway.
Oh, God. Look, I'm sorry. There's something I've got to say.
You want to enjoy your meal?
Oh, lovely, thank you. I suppose I should have been a bit more adventurous.
Oh, there's nothing unadventurous about Cocoa Pops. Oh.
But when I'm really happy, like now, well, I can't help indulging myself.
Oh. All right, Anthea.
So anyway, as I was saying, I've been discussing my career with Dorothy and a friend of mine who works at Vulcan Technology.
Oh, a letter arrived for you today. I'll go and get it.
Now, this friend and I were discussing the work landscape, future-wise, and the prospect of me enlarging their staffing capability spectrum.
I'm not sure that I'm quite following you.
In a nutshell, I think what Gary's saying is... Gary?
Well, I'm trying to explain a delicate matter here, dammit.
No, I think Scott's going to
Yeah, well, if you're so interested, you go and open it. So, anyway, this friend and I both agreed that the time was right to enlarge my career.
Oh, profile, dear.
Prospectively.
How many words? There's birthday charades. That'll liven us all up. All right. Two words. Second word.
Lobe. Dangly lobe.
Sounds like.
Nose.
Course of orthodontical treatment.
The mouth, lips, gob, gob.
Nose.
Can we have our bill, please?
Just shut up.
Sounds like gob. Job.
Nose.
First word. No first word. Nodding job.
Italian job.
Blow job. That doesn't sound right. No job. Nose job.
What's no job supposed to mean? Is it a musical?
Of course it isn't. It's a piece of bad news.
It's me, isn't it? I've got no job. I'm going to lose my job. Okay.
You haven't got the job. They've frozen recruitment.
Never mind, Gary. At least George and Anthony didn't understand a word you were saying.
Hey, smart ass. Bill.
Okay.
It's all right, Anthea. You're not going to lose your job. None of us are. I guess we're just the sort of people who never really go anywhere.
Oh, sorry. I was just being silly.
Oh.
There you go, Anthea. That's from Gary.
Thank you. Happy birthday, Anthea. Thank you and goodbye.
Sometimes I wish I was just a bloody waiter.
she had a bit of cucumber on the side of her mouth. All I did was make a small technical error.
Technical error? The man caught you trying to slip your tongue in his girlfriend's mouth.
I was just trying to be helpful. Overall, though, I think I made a good impression on Deborah, don't you think?
Well, it's hard to say, really, isn't it? The fact that she sacked you isn't a good sign, is it?
Bit of a setback, yeah.
Anyway, I'm off to bed.
Where's Dorothy?
She's got to get up early in the morning, so somebody's ear back on or something.
I better get some sleep myself. Need to get a few things tomorrow.
What, like a job, a girlfriend and a future?
Yeah. Maybe I'll try that new Asda, see if I can get all three under the one roof. Night, Gary.
Night, Dermot.
Night, then.
Night.
Yeah, night.
Night.
Good night.
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 You've always got to speak last, haven't you?
No. Good night.
That's enough.
All right, nine.